The next is circuitous for subtraction. Since we have seen the addition operation, we now need to look at the subtraction. Since we have already discussed about subtraction in the beginning when we have seen the number system, we know that we need not require an explicit circuit for subtraction. The adder itself is able to perform the subtraction since we are going to use the complement operation to perform subtraction. We will have the addition and subtraction together with the same circuit, and this circuit is able to identify the overflow as well. We'll see what is overflow. Now to perform addition or subtraction, we need two inputs. Let's assume that it is A and B. And the operations can be either addition or subtraction. If we wanted to perform addition, we will do A plus B. And for subtraction, we will perform A minus B. For both addition and subtraction, if A is a positive number, it remains as a positive number. We'll assume that it is a positive number. So A is a positive number. And B, here it is a positive number, here it is a negative number. So how we can represent a negative number using the complement notation? And in this particular example, we are going to represent B as 2's complement, minus B in 2's complement. So minus B, I can write it as B complement plus 1. That is 1's complement of B plus 1 will give you the 2's complement of minus B. So we can write minus B as A plus B bar plus 1. And addition we can represent as A plus B plus 0, which is the initial carry. Okay. So for addition we will use 0, and for subtraction we have A plus B bar plus 1. Okay. So this 1 we will use it for subtraction. So let's see how we can use that. Okay. For addition, B has to be supplied as B, right? So suppose if we XOR B with 0, we get B into 1, which is 0 bar, or B bar into 0, which is equal to, so this term will be vanishing and we will get B as output. Suppose if we perform B XORed with 1, we get B into 1 complement, which is 0, or we get B bar into 1. So this term will vanish and we get B bar. Okay, so this is the trick. Okay, so we are going to use 1 for subtraction and 0 for addition. Let's see what is overflow now. Assume that we are using 8 bit numbers to represent signed numbers. So plus 70 we will represent like this. Okay, and this bit, the 8th bit, is going to act as the signed bit. And we are using the complement notation. And plus 80 is this one. And similarly, minus 70 we have represented using the 2's complement, and notice that the sign bit for the negative numbers is 1. And when we add these two numbers, we get a positive 150 as this number. Okay, and this is 1. When we use a 8-bit representation to represent plus 150, in the 8th bit we get a 1, which is going to act as the sign bit. So how the system will interpret this? This representation will be interpreted as a negative number because we have a 1 in the 8th bit, which is wrong. Similarly, when you consider here, when we add these two numbers, we'll get 0 here, and then 1 plus 1 will get 0 here, and then the carry will be propagated to the next bit. This is a overflow. why we call this as a overflow? When we add two bits to two binary numbers which are 8 bits long, here the sum is 8 bits long. So see, when we do addition in a paper, we don't have any restriction in terms of memory. We can write whichever bit that comes here, we can write it here, no issue if we are doing this problem in the paper. But when we consider this operation in a machine, we have restricted memory. Say for example, this number will be in a 8 bit register and this number will be in another 8 bit register, and when we add them together, the result will be stored in another register which will also be 8 bit long. But here you have 9 bit result. You cannot, you know, push this 9 bit result into a 8 bit register. This bit will be lost. So this is called a overflow, and this is also a overflow because this is not the right representation that we expect. If it is a positive number, if we wanted to represent a positive number, the MSB should be 0, but here we have the MSB to be 1. So this is also a overflow. And see here, in both the cases we have the 9th bit to be 0 here, but the 8th bit is 1 here. In this case, the 9th bit is 1, the 8th bit is 0. Both these cases are undesirable, and these two cases we have to detect, and we will have an exclusive circuit to detect this overflow situation. The overflow circuit is going to use the carry that comes as input to the MSB and the carry out from the addition of MSB bit. Only these two bits are of our interest. This is our adder subtractor circuit. M will be 0 for addition and M will be 1 if it is subtraction operation. We have A supplied to the full adder directly, but B we will XOR with either 0. When M is 0, we will XOR with 0 and we get B, and if M is 1, we perform subtraction and B will be supplied as B bar to the full adder. And when M is 0, it is addition operation, so C0 will be 0, the initial carry will be 0. And when M is 1, we need to add this B bar with 1, right? And this C0 will get 1 as input. So we add B bar plus 1 to get the 2's complement of B. So the full adder will add either A plus B, or it adds A plus B bar plus 1 and gives the result. And the overflow will be detected by the carry to the MSB bit, which is C3, XORed with the carry out from MSB, which is C4. And if this is going to be 1, we get a overflow. We have already seen that these are the conditions for overflow, right? I should not get. So this is your C3. This is C3 and this is C4. And similarly here, C3 and C4. And when we XOR this one, 0, 1 on R10, for both these inputs, the XOR output is going to be 1. If both the bits are either zeros or ones, we will get 0 as in output of the XOR operation. So we just use the XOR of the input to the MSB, input carry to the MSB and the output carry from the MSB, and we XOR that to get the overflow. And this overflow will be stored in the status register. When we perform any operation, either addition or subtraction, after the operation is over, we check the status register and check for this overflow bit, and if this bit is 1, then the result stored in the output register is not a valid output. We have to discard that output. Otherwise, it is a valid output. We can use it further in our operation.